Hey guys, Wooly here, and we're back on the Diamonds in the Rough server, and we have a present. Happy 1.3.1, enjoy, and how nice. Some cocoa beans, excellent. Great, well, I'm sure I can think of something to do with those. Thank you, August. So, we're at spawn, and people have been busy. I started spreading some grass over here, and someone's certainly run with that idea and started planting trees, which is lovely. People have been busy around the skelly spawner that I built, and if we look over here, there's a... I don't know what that was. There is a very lovely path, which I believe was the work of Gapehoof of the Toy Strumpets duo. So thank you very much. There's also a lot of stuff been done over at the Skelly Spawner. Enderman. And we'll just take care of this guy. Come on. Come at me. By far the easiest way to fight these guys. And a pearl. Excellent. Right, anyway. Now it is getting night, and I am the only one on. So, hey! Might as well go and make it day. Okay. Also get rid of this rain. I should do. Yep. Brilliant. So, grass is being spread all over the place around here. This is still under construction. I know he's been digging. A long way. Which is nice. Anyone leave anything for me? No, not since last time. All the cows are gone. I guess that's because I've opened the cow farm up. And let's... Yes, of course. So we've got this big pyramid. So Goody Good Hugh has always been on the server longer than me, but he's started building. And he is building this pyramid, and if we just have a quick look inside, sneaky look inside, Goody's amazing pyramid. Not done yet, so we'll only be in a moment. Yep, so he's building, oh, I thought that was the bow of a skelly there, he's building a maze. Whoa! Oh my, that would have been a bad start to the video, blowing up someone else's stuff. Oh dear. Yeah, so it looks like the maze is going to go up multiple floors, so I do believe I remember him saying in his video that he's maybe going to put some prize at the top, so we'll be sure to make have a go at that when it's done. Now some kind person has built a road all the way out to my farm, which is good, very nice, thank you whoever you are. And speaking of the farm, I have been busy. And we've got this lovely hedge and Willie's farm, taking advantage of the new sideways logs there for the entrance. And we go down this tree-lined path, and if you remember, all of this was desert. And you, in fact, you can see where the grass changes colour there. So you can see where I've been, and I've around here, I've pretty much taken it down one level and replaced it with dirt and let the grass spread. There was a pretty large hill here, and yeah, that is no more. So I excavated a hill, and let's have a look at our cows. Lots and lots, all grown up. I don't know if we've got any wheat on us. I'm not sure whether what I've built since the last episode. This is my ice rink. Pretty much the same as what I built in the Wonderful World of Woolly for harvesting ice with my Silk Touch spade, which is the only Silk Touch tool I've been able to enchant so far. Do, 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 do. Yeah, have that. Let's clear some of this out. Get rid of that. Been taking bows every so often from the a few bows back with me when I'm at the Skelly Farm enchanting, because I figure they'll come in useful for dispensers. So far I've enchanted this, and so I've got a couple of fortune picks. Just did an unbreaking and efficiency. This was, I believe this was the only level 50 I've done on this server. That was a stunning pick. Efficiency for Fortune 2, not as good as my previous shovel that did all the work out of the desert. That was a hell of a spade, that was. Let's see. What we'll do is we'll take some bone meal. Yeah, we'll take some bone meal. And we'll quickly bone the wheat so we can rebreed after harvesting our cows. Now, obviously, this is just a temporary wheat field. I'm gonna have. I'm undecided at the moment whether to have. There's definitely going to be a pretty massive wheat field, but I'm undecided whether it's going to be a working wheat field, or whether I'm gonna basically have a massive wheat field for show, and then have a bread maker or something for actually getting wheat. So obviously the thing is, if I do a working wheat field, I need to think about water flushing and also, you know, ease of replanting, being able to move around it without trampling the dirt, and also I need to think about hydration. Now, if I just do one for show, I can just, with the aid of bone meal, I can make a massive wheat field that is pretty much non-harvestable, basically. It'll be, you could harvest it, but you know, it'd be a pain in the ass to use in that way, but every farm requires wheat fields of wheat. This one should be no exception. So, yeah, let's just grab these. Oh, you do, bruh. Nope. Right. I'm actually doing quite well for pumpkins at the moment, so let's put that back there. It's just a temporary measure. Now, first thing we're going to do here is harvest. Oh, harvest some beef. Come on, out of the fire. Why does that happen sometimes? Sometimes they will survive. I don't quite... I think it might be an SMP inconsistency issue. Thing is, if I make them take any more fall damage, they're going to be very reluctant to actually come down here. Come on, guys. Okay, I think that's enough. Oh, come on. Forward. Right. Excellent. Okay, so... what do we need to do? We'll drop our seeds off. There we go. And we'll go and breed these guys. Now, I must admit, I put this gantry into... mean that you didn't have to do this and jump in to breed them, but it's just so much quicker and easier, especially now they've removed the force field on mobs. Oh, iPhone's on. You don't get pushed around nearly as much. Are we done? I think we're done. Right. Say hello to... Oh! YouTube. Maybe he's just got a trunk error. Maybe he'll be back on. No? Okay. That was quick on and off. Okay. Don't know what happened there. Maybe he lost his net connection. Right, let's drop some of this off. Oh, cool. Got enough. I think I've got enough gold now for today's project, which is good. Okay, let's see. do that. Brilliant. Put you in there for safekeeping. You in there. Right. Now. That beef that we just... harvested is not actually for me. I did promise August of Midnight a stack of beef in return for my favourite record in the game, because I'm too lazy to get it. And I think what we'll do is I'll head on over to August's and drop my payment off, and then after we've done that, we'll come back here. I'll see you over there. Okay, so we're at August's, and apparently sheep are what she wants. Respects. Okay. Should we leave it in the mailbox? I guess we should actually leave it in the mailbox. Made a chest, but yeah, there's no need to clutter a place up with chests, is there? Woolly creeper. Here we go. Hello. Cool. I really can't wait for August's next video. I've been and had a look around her underground village precinct jobby, and there's a couple of rooms in there that she's making a good start with that, I think. So I'd be interested to see what she comes up with next. But anyway, back to the farm. And I shall see you over there. Okay, so we're back, and what I'm going to do today is I'm going to at least make a start on something to deal with these guys. Now, this thing is it's pretty good, actually. However, there are a few things. Firstly, I'm not actually entirely certain that the water is necessary anymore. For all that it's done wrong, 1.3 does seem to, for the most part anyway, have fixed the majority of the mob glitchiness thing, where they derp around and go through blocks. Now, I've got these guys. I've not had them long, only a few hours, but none of them have even made any semblance of derping through the fence or through the hedge. So, but then, you know, who knows? They're not really crowded in there yet. So that's one thing to consider. Another thing to consider is breeding them and killing them. Now, the use of the netherrack in that farm is not really ideal. You lose a few. You lose a few cattle simply through them being too stupid to actually get out of the fire, which is irritating. So I think we're going to want to switch for the pigs, and possibly in the future for the cows as well, is to use a lava cooker instead, which with dispensers should be very, very easy to do. So that's another thing to consider. And the final thing is the breeding. Now, obviously the simplest way of doing things is to breed them en masse, like I do with the like we currently do with the cow farm. But you know, I don't know. I just quite fancy trying my hand at some animal breeding gizmo, so I'm gonna build an animal breeding gizmo. I guess that's all there is to it. No. Nothing more profound than that. So what we're going to do is we're going to build an animal breeder in this area here. And the idea being we're going to have our pig pen in this area, and the animal breeder will deliver pigs to that area, and then we'll incorporate a cooker on there. Now the advantage is if we're breeding from an animal breeder, then we can kill everything in the pen, basically, as long as the animal breeder has the capacity to refill the pen in one or two breeding cycles. Then, you know, we're golden on that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay out some groundwork for the breeder and come back to you. Okay, so I've laid some groundwork out here, and what I'm going to do is, well, I'm not going to have time to build this in this episode, so I'm going to take you through my thinking at the moment, and that is we're going to have the pigs sat in carts like on these blocks here, like so, and then we shall have, I don't want those gaps, we'll have water streams down here. We'll jump down here, in fact. So we shall have water streams down here. And so when you breed them, they'll breed in pairs. This is should be too far to allow them to breed. They'll breed in pairs. So at the moment, this layout will get 6 calves per breeding cycle, but you can just extend it that direction, or I will extend it that direction, I think. The calves get washed down here, down these steps, so they don't take any damage. We'll pop, oh, I've got any on me, we'll pop signs along here to stop the water, and have a water stream along here. Probably need it to be too deep so that we can extend it. Yeah. So they'll come down here. here, and then we'll elevate them up with water. And this is where that comes out. And what we'll do is I'll make this like a drinking trough or something. You know, something that looks like part of the pen. And when you breed them, they'll come up out of here and sit in here, and then we'll devise a way of killing them, which may well involve carrying them off to another building, rather than having them, the killing device associated with the pen itself. So the pen is pretty much just for show. I mean, you could store them in a 1x1 hole, but I want this to actually look like a farm. So yields, that is what we're going to do after I've killed this guy. I think when I come to building the farmhouse, I'm going to build it on this hill here, so it overlooks the farm quite, it should overlook the farm quite nicely from there. It's quite a commanding position. For I am a gentleman farmer, don't you know? Right. Anyway, so that is the plan. And we'll, over the top of this, we will build a barn using normal wood for the walls, and dark wood for the ceiling roof. I think that's how we'll do it. And we'll get on with that, and I will see you next episode. Thanks for watching.